Today's video is all about the concept of multiple adaptive regression spline for financial analytics. So I am not going to that much of mathematical detail, what a software engineer or a computer scientist will prefer, but this is designed more to the financial analytics side. We will be using multiple adaptive regression spline, or what popularly called as MARS, for the financial analytics prediction model. So let's start the journey without wasting some time. So MARS is a form of a stepwise linear regression, and it was introduced by Jerome Friedman. It was later taken by Salford Predictive Modeler, and it was copyrighted by Salford. Later Salford was merged with a company called Minitab, and a lot of other softwares also use it, but since they can't use the word MARS, they use the word Earth, or some people call it MARS splines, like Statistica use it as MARS splines. So extension of linear model that can model non-linearity, that's a very interesting thing. So MARS models are simpler compared to random forest or compared to neural network. It's a very simple model, but very effective model. So what you are seeing right now in the screen is the least square, or the OLS, linear regression model, where there is a regression line that is represented in the black line. Some points are closer to the line, some points are away from the line. But if the points are too much away, and if it is scattered, say suppose like something like this, then it becomes very difficult to fit a straight line. We can fit a polynomial instead, but even that for measurement, if we fit a parabola also, it may miss a lot of points. So it won't serve the purpose. So that is why this is done, what you are seeing right now. So two things are done. First of all, blocks of data are segregated into boxes, and then separate OLS regression is done for all those small patches of data. So there is kind of a sliding window to divide the data into smaller blobs or kind of patches, and at each data point use a type of least square to fit the, you can see the least square line, the black line for each red blobs, and the blobs actually are overlapping, and the least square lines are also overlapping. The point they are connecting, the point to black line is connecting, that point is called knot, and we will learn about it in some. So let's start again. We will now go to the next part. So a normal regression, you can see just below my photo that there is a normal regression pattern. On the other side of the screen, there is a MARS pattern. So you can see the difference. For a normal regression, it's a simple y equal to a plus bx, where a is an intercept. Here it is minus 37, and b is equal to 5.1. But in case of MARS, you can see a max function, and that max function is denoted by a range. The range is between, say, it's between 0 to x minus a, and the other part is 0 to a minus x. Here the value of a is 13. So basically 0 to x minus a and 0 to a minus x. That is a concept that gets connected, and that's how the MARS function. You can see there is a small joining point. That joining point is the knot. Here it is one knot. That is why you can see there are two equations on both the sides of the knots. There are two linear equations both the sides of the knots. One linear equation is this one, second is this one. If there would have been, suppose, two knots, obviously there would have been a third linear equation which will add into this part. So that is the concept of this. I'm trying to keep it simple so that everyone can understand. So it is, the name is quite large, as we know, multivariate adaptive regression spline. So let's understand and decode each word. So multivariate because it's able to generate model based of several input variables, the x variables are many, more than one, 10, 12, 13, 14, 25. I have myself used up to 37 x variables. So that is why it is called multivariate. Adaptive because generates flexible models in passes each time adjusting the model. So that is why it is called adaptive. Regression because based on the past data, it tries to predict the future. That's why it's called regression. Estimating the relationship among independent and depending variables. Spline, that's very interesting. Spline is a mathematical concept, a piecewise defined polynomial function that is smooth, possesses a higher order derivatives, where polynomial pieces connect. That connection point, as I told you, is called the knot. And so multiple polynomial points are here which are getting connected. So I will just go back to the diagram. Here you can see the connection points. 1, 2, here there is no connect, it's parallel. 3, here also no connect, here also no connect. So there are 3 knots here, you can see that. So let's go back to the part where we were. So now, how multiple adaptive regression spline or MARS works, let's delve into that a little bit. So MARS is a non-parametric algorithm that creates a piecewise linear model to capture the non-linearities into interactions effect. The resulting model is a weighted sum of the basis functions. So it's not taking directly x1, x2, x3, x4. As I showed you, it is taking between 0 to x minus a and 0 to a minus x. Between that range it takes. So that's why it's called basis function rather than the x variable. So the basis functions are either a constant. So intercept is a constant. We all know that's the minimum value of y for all the x parameters being 0. So that's a constant. Other than intercept, a hinge function in the form of, so that's called a hinge function, that max 0 to x minus x0. x0 also we can call it a. I prefer it as a. So x minus a. So 0 to x minus a and 0 to a minus x. Though those functions are called hinge functions. Those max functions that you saw already, those are called hinge functions. So a hinge function from 0 to x minus x0, or as I called x minus a, or max 0 to a minus x, or x0 minus x, a more concise representation is plus minus obviously, or products of two or more hinge functions or interactions. MARS automatically selects which predictor to use and what predictor values to serve as the knots of the hinge function. So that predictor values, MARS selects by a lot of iteration, forward passes and backward passes, very similar to neural network, the forward propagation and the back propagation, very similar, but not exactly the same. So MARS build a model in two phases, the forward pass and the backward pass, as I was talking, like input to output is forward pass and output to input is backward pass, similar to growing and pruning of tree models. So MARS is an extension of CART, classification and regression tree. So obviously pruning is very important. Pruning is undue cutting off or chopping off of the undue stuff in the model. So that's called pruning. MARS starts with a model consisting of just one intercept term equaling the mean of the response values. It then assesses every single predictor to find a basis function pair consisting of opposing sides of a mirror imaged hinge function. Mirror image means, as I showed you, 0 to x minus a and 0 to a minus x. That's why it's called mirror image hinge function. Pair consisting of opposite sides of a mirrored hinge function, which produces the maximum improvement on the model error. So by that, the maximum improvement of model error is possible. MARS repeats the process until either it reaches a predefined limit of terms of the error improvement reaches a predefined limit. MARS generalizes the model by removing terms according to the generalized cross validation error. That's basically a criterion. GCV is a form of regularization. It trades off goodness of fit against model complexity. So it takes care of goodness of fit, but it does not let the model to become very complex. So it's kind of a controlling mechanism between the complexity and the robustness of the model. So GCV, or generalized cross validation, is a very important criterion for MARS. So there is an Earth function in RStudio, and that's an open source function. Otherwise, if you use Statistica, it's called Mars Splines. If you use Salford Minitab, then it is called Mars, because still the copyright is with Salford and now Minitab is merged with it. Okay, so that's a maximum degree of interaction, given that default is 1 for interactions. Obviously, maximum number is more than that. In my experience, it's closer to 20 sometimes also. It goes as far as 20 as well. So, however, there are other hyperparameters in the model that may improve the performance, including the mind span, which regulates the number of the knots of the predictors. So now, let's see the paper which have actually put this Mars into picture. So let me show you the paper once. I think I have to take my photo out. Yeah, this is the paper. This is the original paper. As I don't know whether you can see completely, this is the original paper. Multivariate adaptive regression spline by Jerome Friedman, Stanford Linear Accelerator Center, Department of Statistics, Stanford University, California. So all the things that I have said in this video is basically a representation, adaptation, and a easy understanding from this paper derived. So hooked onto the video for the next part, which is the actual work on this, on the data to predict certain predictive algorithm. Thank you very much and stay tuned. So I hope the concept video of multiple adaptive regression spline was good enough to generate interest and keep you hooked up till the end. Please watch this space out and subscribe my channel, and please, if you like this concept video, give me a thumbs up. And the next video will show with data how we can use multiple adaptive regression spline for defaulter prediction. Thank you for watching this space.